Hi folks, nice on Android.com where we get on Android every day. Anyway, today we're going to go ahead and learn how to install a new custom ROM. For this example, I'll be installing CM12. Also, this will be a fail-proof method, so hopefully you'll be able to install it the first time instead of the second time or ending up in a boot loop. I've realized over the years that formatting system is necessary for good installation. Usually you just do, a factory reset and then install ROM. That doesn't format system, and sometimes when you install ROMs like CyanogenMod 12 or CM11 or any of the AOSP ROMs, sometimes what happens is you install the ROM and you end up in a boot loop and you have to format the system anyways and do this second time. So in this tutorial, I'll be giving you a universal method on how to install ROM and make it boot the first time. Before we do this, make sure you make a backup ROM before you do it. Also, we'll be using TWRP Recovery to do this. You can also use CWM Clock Mod Recovery. I'll have another video with that, but the instructions are pretty much the same, just the menus are slightly different. So let's go ahead and install CM12 on my T-Mobile Note 4. Also, this is universal method for all kinds of Android devices, whether you have a Note 3, HTC One, Nexus 5, Nexus 6. If you have TWRP Recovery installed, you can follow the same exact method to install the ROM. So let's go ahead and do this, baby. All right, before we begin, you should have downloaded the ROM zip file straight to your phone, or you can download it to your computer and copy it over. If it's a large file, I do recommend make sure you have stable internet, download it on your computer and copy it over. If you don't want the ROM file to take up space, you can also download it onto a USB flash drive here. Use an OTG cable, that's a good way too. Or you can just download it, install the ROM, and then erase the ROM zip file. You don't need it after. Now, ROMs like CM12 will actually have separate file for the Play Store and your Google Apps, which is called GApps. So make sure you download that too if you're installing CM12 or CM11 or any of the CyanogenMod or any AOSP ROMs. So once you have downloaded it onto your phone, let me go ahead and show you. Verify that you have the files downloaded. All right, and here we go. And you can see I have CM12 there. All right. Oh, actually, you know what? I have it in my other storage. Sorry. You can put it in your internal storage, your micro SD card, or you can put it in your OTG flash drive. There we go. CM12 and GApps. That's all I need. Now, sometimes these zip files are bad, so let me go ahead and show you how to do that. What you'll need to download is this thing called ES File Explorer app, and this will show you if the file is good or not. You can also check the MD5. Or just a simpler way, is just download ES File Explorer. So that way you don't have to check the MD5. Now, all these ROM zip files are in zip files. Do not unzip them after you download it. If you download on your computer, copy the whole zip file onto your phone. You can also check the integrity of the zip file on your computer. Just see if you can open it. If you can actually open the file to unzip, then that means the file is okay. That way we can go ahead and bypass the MD5, checking the MD5 of the file. There we go. So let me go ahead and open it. And go ahead and find the file. So if you keep clicking here, it'll probably show you the file it's in. All right. And if I plug this in, it should also show you my USB storage here in a couple seconds. All right. Let me go ahead and show you the file here. Oops, there we go, like I told you. So let me go ahead and do this. There we go. Now you see USB drive. If you're using USB drive, you can do that. Also, go ahead and find the zip file, the ROM zip file you download it. All right, and it's in my download. And you can see this file here. Let me change the view to make it like that. If you actually click on the zip file and choose Easy Viewer, and you can actually open it like this, which shows the contents of the file. That means your file download is okay. So if it doesn't install, don't blame it on the file download. That's great, all right? Because a lot of times people, they install the ROM and it just immediately fails. And the first thing I asked him is, you know, is did you download the file? Is it okay? Is it, you know, is it bigger than 0 bytes? Sometimes it downloads at 0 bytes. So this is one way you can check it. Also the gapps. Let me set this as default. You can see it open. So these two files are good to go. Once you have good files, we are ready to go with the next step. So for let's reboot into recovery, and I actually don't need this. I'm actually not using my micro USB flash there. Go ahead and you can use a quick boot app. You can get on the Play Store. All right. Ooh, no root access. So for some reason, I don't have root access. But if you do have root, you can go ahead and simply select recovery here, and it will boot you into recovery. Now, if you don't have root for some reason, and maybe you just install TWRP on top of your stock recovery, with the Samsung phones, you can go ahead and hold down volume up, center home, and the power button for about 5 seconds or 3 seconds. And if you see recovery booting, you can go ahead and let go of the buttons. Now, if you're using Nexus devices or HTC One, it's volume down and power. Hold it until you see the bootloader menus, and then choose recovery and hit the power button, and then you should be in TWRP. If you don't see this, that means you don't have TWRP recovery installed. You might have something else like ClockMod recovery, which the instructions is pretty much the same if it's SCWM recovery or Phil's recovery at the top. But if you see like green Android guy with just 4 menus or 5 menus, that's stock recovery. You don't even have any kind of custom recovery. So if that's the case, you'll have to install TWRP recovery. Anyway, let's go ahead and install this ROM. So this is the fail-proof method, in my opinion. So the first thing you should do is go to wipe. And don't do the factory reset. Go to advanced wipe. All right. And then do wipe system, data, dial the cache. All right, like that. Oh, and cache also. This way, you're actually formatting system. The regular factory reset only formats data, dial the cache, and cache. You should actually really format system also. Now, wiping your system data, dial the cache, and cache, this will erase everything on your phone except your personal files and videos. So all your settings, all your apps, all your app data is going to be gone, zip. So at this point, if you did not make a backup ROM, abort this, go back home and hit the backup button. Otherwise, we're going to go ahead and wipe Dalvik system data and cache, all right? And we're going to go ahead and data to wipe. If you made a backup ROM, you can always restore your ROM, which is here. All right, formatting system. All right, unable to mount storage. Don't worry about that. Sometimes you get these errors. Sometimes it's like a bug or something, but it works just fine. All right, and then we'll go to install, and then go ahead and choose the storage you're going to use. For me, it's in micro SD card. If you download it straight to your phone, it's most likely in your internal storage and your download folder, but I didn't. So I'm going to go to my micro SD card, download folder. I'm going to choose CM12. All right, I'm going to go ahead and do that. And this will install the ROM. Now, some ROMs, they come with this thing called Aroma Graphical Installer. And what that is basically it gives you options, graphical options that you can do a whole bunch of stuff. So go through that and install it if that's the case. But if it's not, it should say successful when it's done. It might take you longer. I have a Note 4. If you have like a Note 2, it might take like 20 seconds. All right, go back home and go ahead and go back to install. If you're installing like a CM12, if you're installing just a regular ROM that does not require gapps, then you can go ahead and just reboot. But this one requires it because it's a CyanogenMod 12 ROM. And confirm to flash gapps, Google apps. And that's pretty much done. Home and reboot. Now the only thing we did different, instead of doing the standard wipe, which wipes data cache Dalvik, went to advanced wipe and added system. That usually, you know, makes everything correct. And I found out that 1 out of every 10 flashes, it fails if you just use a regular. So this way it's more or less fail proof. And we'll go ahead and reboot system. And I know some of you are like, why don't you like clean the fingerprints off your phone before you make the video? Well, there you go. Now you don't have to troll. There we go, and hopefully it works. But I'm telling you, this method, formatting the system, usually will boot. And 99% of the time, the questions I get is this, because they didn't format system, I tell them to format system and reinstall the ROM. And then sometimes people don't know how to do it. So I made this video so to clear it up, so I don't get all these questions, and so your ROM boots the first time. If there's nothing wrong with the ROM, 9 out of 10 times in my experience, I have booted a custom ROM every time I've installed it. But if you don't format system, maybe 3 out of 10 times it'll fail boot loop, especially if you're going from like a touchless ROM to a CM ROM, or our sense ROM to a CM ROM, or back and forth. One of the reasons that I can say, for those of you interested, is because the file structure may be different, and if you don't format system, sometimes it gets corrupted while you're switching between those type of different ROMs. But this way, everything just cleared off the system, and it's just like formatting your hard disk before you install new Windows or something. So that's what we did, and it should boot up here in a sec. And usually it should take, CM12 actually takes a really long time. CM11, like the older KitKat, they'll boot up pretty quickly. This one takes sometimes 5 minutes. So I will be back when this boots up completely. And boom shakalaka. My ROM did boot after about 2 minutes, depending on the phone you have. If you have a fast processor, it's gonna boot up faster. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and go in here. I'm gonna skip anyway. As you can see, I was able to install it from a TouchWiz to CM12 on my first try. So this should help you, and as long as you see the welcome sign, you should be good to go. And you can see I'm already picking up data. I'm good to go, and I've got my Google Play Store, everything working out of the box. So that's how you can install a custom ROM. Now, this is a universal method for all kind of rooted Android smartphones, tablets, and also should work for all types of different ROMs. So if you're always asking, some people ask me, like, you know, if I introduce a new ROM like CM12 ROM, like, Max, how do you install CM12? It's the same method. They're all the same method, you know? So I just want to make this one video for all the different phones. That way I don't have to make it again. All the ROMs are exactly the same how you install it. But I only show you a little trick. A formatting system will usually guarantee like 99% of the time your ROM will boot the first time. I hope this video has helped you. And thanks guys for watching this video. This video should help you install your favorite custom ROM in just one shot. Now, if you end up in a boot loop, 99% of the time, that ROM's probably bad, or something's up with your bootloader. It doesn't match the ROM you're installing. You know, you can go ahead and try this method maybe like 2 more times, and if it doesn't boot, it's the ROM's fault, or you have a wrong bootloader for the ROM. Other than that, your ROM should be booting and you should be on your new custom ROM. Anyway, thanks guys for watching this video. As always, don't forget to hit that like, subscribe, and as always, stay on Android.